Hi. Last class, I've discussed about the step up, step down DC choker. Today, I will discuss commutation circuit for DC chokers. Commutation is nothing but turning of a thyristor. Now, why it is required? In case of DC supply, natural reverse voltage is not coming to turn off the thyristor, as we have seen in case of AC supply. So, to turn off the thyristor, we have to take help of some external circuitry. So, the circuit developed to turn off the thyristor is known as commutation circuit. So, there are basically three types of commutation circuit: voltage commutation, current commutation, and load commutation. Today, I will discuss about these things. So, let's start. First of all, what is commutation? The process of turning of a conducting thyristor is called commutation. In DC chopper, it is essential to provide a separate commutation circuitry to commutate the main SCR, because natural reverse voltage is not coming to turn off the thyristor. So, you have to commutate using some external circuitry or separate commutation circuit we have to develop. Basically, two types of commutation circuits are there: forced commutation and load commutation. In forced commutation, you will see voltage commutation and current commutation. In voltage commutation, we will take help of inductor and capacitor to develop reverse voltage across the thyristor to turn the thyristor off. In current commutation, we will apply a reverse current to the thyristor, and when the reverse current becomes equal to the current flowing through the thyristor, then net current through the thyristor becomes zero, and this current is less than the holding current, the thyristor will be automatically turned. Now, load commutation. Load commutation, you can say, because of the nature of the load, thyristor is automatically commutated. You can see this circuit diagram. Here, a DC voltage is connected in series with a thyristor, capacitor, and R. We can assume this R and C as a load. So, whenever thyristor is made on, current will flow through the thyristor to charge the capacitor. Now, we know that as current is flowing through the capacitor, so voltage across the capacitor will increase, and the potential difference between this DC input and capacitor voltage will decrease, and current will become zero at a point when this capacitor voltage becomes equal to the DC input voltage. And during that duration, if the thyristor current becomes less than the holding current, then the thyristor will become off. So, because of the nature of the load, thyristor is automatically turned off. So, this kind of commutation circuit is known as load commutation. Now, let's discuss about this voltage commutation. To understand this voltage commutation, we have to go through some basic circuits. So, this is LC oscillation circuit. In this circuit, what will happen? A pre-charged capacitor is there. Now, this charged capacitor, when it is connected through a diode and a switch and an inductor, then suppose the polarity of the upper plate of the capacitor is positive and the lower plate is negative, then this diode will get forward bias. Then current will flow in this direction when the switch is made on. So the current will flow like this. Now, during this period, what will happen is the current will increase through this inductor. So inductor will get charge and it will store some amount of energy. At the same time, we can see the same current is entering through this capacitor. That means capacitor is discharging inductor is charging, then again capacitor is charging. So after some time you will see the capacitor voltage polarity is reversed. Earlier it was positive negative, now it will be negative positive. The reason behind it is that the current is entering towards this lower plate. That's why the lower plate will become positive and upper plate negative. And this negative will appear across the anode of the diode, and the diode will get reverse bias. So ultimately you will see the polarity of this capacitor voltage is reversed, and this reverse voltage is applied across the thyristor to turn the thyristor off. So we will see this. So we have to take help of this kind of circuit in voltage computation. So let's analyze this circuit in detail. You can see we have started with this polarity, positive negative. Now switch just turned on and diode gets forward biased. So the diode will get forward biased and current will flow in this direction, and the polarity across the inductor you will see positive negative. So here the inductor is getting charged. After some time you will see the polarity of the capacitor is reversed and the inductor polarity is also reversed, because the inductor has also completely discharged and the capacitor is charged. So at the end of the period you will see that the capacitor voltage polarity is reversed. Let's see the current, inductor voltage and capacitor voltage waveform. See, so this is the current flowing through the LC oscillator circuit. This is our inductor voltage and this is capacitor voltage. This capacitor voltage I have taken negative. The reason behind it is that current is entering towards this capacitor, that's why this is negative voltage, and this one positive voltage as it is entering towards this one. Now from the basics we know that in case of inductive load, current lags the inductor voltage. Here this inductor voltage is at maximum value, then the current is zero. So the current is lagging this inductor voltage. At the same time we know that current leads the capacitor voltage, because inductor and capacitor are connected in series. So the same current is flowing through the inductor as well as the capacitor. So our basics should be valid in this case also. So this capacitor voltage is negative and the current is zero. So we can say our current is leading the capacitor voltage. Now at this point, if we are assuming that voltage of the capacitor is V, then stored energy across the capacitor is half CV square, and the stored energy across the inductor we know at that point half into L into I square. Now at this point the current is zero, so the stored energy across the inductor it is zero. Now you see this capacitor is now discharging. That means capacitor is releasing its electrostatic energy. Now the current is increasing, so the inductor is storing now energy, and the inductor is storing its energy in electromagnetic field. Now till this point you can see at the maximum point, at this maximum point your voltage is zero but the current is maximum. So the stored energy across the inductor is maximum, and that is half into L into I maximum square. At this point you can see the voltage across the capacitor is what, zero. So the electrostatic energy of the capacitor is half C into zero square, that means zero. So we can say that at this point all the electrostatic energy of the capacitor is converted to electromagnetic energy of the inductor. Now from this point this current is decreasing. We know that if the current decreases through the inductor, then the polarity of the inductor reverses. So you can see here. So after this point, the inductor voltage is now negative. So it is now changing the energy. So it is now changing its polarity. At the same time, this current is decreasing. So the inductor is now releasing its energy. And we can see the capacitor voltage is increasing. That means the inductor is now releasing the energy and the capacitor is storing that energy. Slowly the capacitor will reach to its maximum value. So at this point the current is zero. So we can say all the electromagnetic energy of the inductor is now converted to electrostatic energy of the capacitor. So at this point again the capacitor has stored same amount of energy if it is a lossless system. So at the end of this period, what is the observation? That initially the capacitor voltage was negative, now the capacitor voltage is positive. That means capacitor has changed its polarity. So this is very effective circuit, and this voltage can be applied to turn off the SCR, and we will use this circuit for voltage commutation. So let's see this one. At the same time, you can observe that inductor voltage also changed its polarity and the current is zero. So let's take a circuit. So in this circuit you can see there are various components connected. The purpose of this circuit is to supply this DC energy to this load. So this load you can assume as a motor load or L1E, RLE load. Now you want to run this motor, so we have to supply the energy, voltage and current, to run this motor. So to run this motor, you have to trigger this SCR number 1. Now if you want to stop that motor, so you have to turn off this SCR number 1. Now to turn off this SCR number 1, the same circuit here I have developed to commutate this SCR number 1. So you can see this is your capacitor, then this switch, diode, inductor. Just forget about this SCR first. See here, this capacitor, then this one is the switch, then this inductor, and this is your diode. You can compare that circuit. Here capacitor, switch, diode, inductor, all are connected in series. So same circuit is here developed. Capacitor, switch, inductor, diode. Okay. Now to supply power to the load, thyristor number 1 is triggered. Before that, what was our assumption? That we have to take a pre-charged capacitor, as I have started with this one, that this capacitor should be charged. So to charge this capacitor, you can develop a circuit across this one through a switch or resistor. To just make the switch on, then this DC voltage will charge this capacitor with this polarity, positive, negative. Then remove that switch. So that circuit I have not connected to reduce the complexity of the system. So a pre-charged capacitor is required. Now the capacitor is charged with this polarity, positive, negative. Now see, as soon as this SCR number 1 is turned on, then there will be two current flowing through this SCR. This current from the source, it will flow in this direction. At the same time, you will see this capacitor is also getting path to discharge its energy, and this capacitor will discharge in this direction. Then what you will see, after some time this capacitor will change its polarity. So you can see in this circuit, so the capacitor polarity is now reversed. at the same time inductor polarity is also reversed, and at this state we can say our diode is now reversed bias. So the capacitor is now ready with this polarity, negative positive. Now whenever you want to turn off this SCR number 1, you have to turn on the SCR number 2. Then what will happen? Once you have given firing pulses to SCR number 2, then current will be shifted from this to this part. Like this current will flow. Again, I am repeating this one. You want to turn off this SCR number 1. Your capacitor is ready with this polarity and you turn on the SCR number 2. Once you have turned on the SCR number 2, so the current will flow in this direction. In this direction the current will flow. Now what is the reason? Current shifted from SCR number 1 to SCR number 2. The reason behind it is that this capacitor is negatively charged. So the potential difference between this input voltage and this capacitor is maximum. So current always chooses minimum impedance path. So here the minimum impedance path is this one. So capacitor is ready to absorb the energy. So high amount of current will flow through this one. Because the capacitor from this negative voltage will come to zero, then to positive voltage. So the potential difference here it is more. So more current will flow through this one, this part. So what will be the effect on this thyristor number 1? The current is now shifted from here to here. So the current through the SCR 1 will reduce less than the holding current and the thyristor number 1 will be on. At the same time you can see this negative voltage is across this one and the positive voltage is appeared across this one, because SCR number 2 is now on. So this positive will come here and this positive will be here. So this positive is connected across anode and this negative is connected across, sorry, at the same time you can see as soon as this current is shifted from SCR number 1 to SCR number 2, this negative voltage will appear across the anode of this SCR number 1 and this positive will come at this point because SCR number 2 is now on. So this positive across cathode, this negative across anode. So the SCR number 1 will be turned off. So our purpose is fulfilled. We have tried to make the thyristor number 1 off. So it is now off. Now what will happen to SCR number 2? Now SCR number 2, as this current is flowing in this direction, now this is a capacitor. So this capacitor will charge. So starting from negative voltage, it will come to zero voltage, then to a voltage equal to this DC input voltage, and the capacitor will develop its initial polarity like this, positive negative. Now as soon as this polarity is developed, that means this voltage becomes equal to this DC input voltage, then the current automatically it will be zero. So the current will not flow through this thyristor now. So this thyristor is now completely off, and this you can assume as a load commutation. Because of this one, the thyristor is now off. So initially we have made thyristor number 1 off, then thyristor number 2 is automatically off because of this capacitor. Now let's see what will happen to the load side. Now when any of this thyristor was on, then current will flow in this direction to the load. Now when both the thyristors are off, then what will happen to this load? Now you can see when thyristor number 1 was on or 2 was on, the polarity across the output voltage you will see like this, positive negative. At the same time polarity across the inductor voltage you will see positive negative. Now as soon as the current is zero, both the thyristors are off, then this inductor will reverse its polarity and it will try to discharge the stored energy across the inductor. Now if this inductor voltage is more than this back EMF voltage or battery voltage, then this positive will come across this anode and this negative will come across this cathode. Then this diode will be forward bias. This diode is known as freewheeling diode. So the inductor will release its energy in this direction, and the output voltage, you can say that when this freewheeling diode D2 is on, then the output voltage becomes zero. As we know that when the diode is on, voltage across this one is 0.7 volt, or ideally you can take zero. So when these two thyristors are off, then this inductor will release its energy and finally this voltage will be zero. After that, if it is a battery source, then E will get across the output, or if it is a motor, then voltage will be zero. Now let's analyze the complete waveform of the circuit. You can see that gate pulses of SCR number 2 and SCR number 1. Now here, just to understand that SCR number 1 is off or not, here firing pulses are given. So when you want to supply power to the load, then you give firing pulses to SCR number 1. So once you have given firing pulses to SCR number 1, you will see this is your current through the SCR number 1. Now this current through the SCR number 1, you will see there is a spike coming. So this spike is because of the discharging current of the capacitor as well as this current. Now this capacitor is discharging for a very small duration of time, because after that this diode will get reverse bias and polarity will be reversed. So the current will be zero. So the discharging current will not be there across the circuit. That's why for a small duration of time you can see the pulse. So it is coming. So during this period the capacitor has changed its polarity. Now normal current will flow through the load. Now you want to turn off the SCR number 1, so you have given firing pulses to SCR number 2. So at this instant SCR number 2 is now on. So as soon as 2 is on, current will be shifted from SCR number 1 to SCR number 2, as we have discussed. So as soon as 2 is made on, here the current will be shifted from 1 to 2. So the current will flow in this direction. So the SCR number 1 current will be 0. So current will flow in this direction like this. So at this point SCR current is now 0. Again you want to start your motor, then you have to turn on the SCR number 1. So like this it will continue. Now for SCR number 2, you will see when SCR number 2 is made on, this current spike you are getting. Now this current spike is because of this one, because the polarity of this capacitor voltage is now negative. So potential difference between this capacitor voltage and DC input voltage is more, so high amount of current initially it will flow, and as soon as this capacitor is getting charged, so the current slowly reduces and exponentially it will decay to zero. So that current we have seen here. So this current is decaying to zero. Now at this point we can say when the current is zero, thyristor number 2 is also off. Okay, now when 1 was again on, at this point you want to make it off again, you have to give the firing pulses to SCR number 2. Then again the same waveform you will see, and here SCR number 2 again it will be off. So likewise it will continue. So whenever you want to make that, run your motor, give firing pulses to SCR number 1, and when you want to switch off the motor supply, then give firing pulses to SCR number 2. So from here it is clear that by applying a gate pulse to SCR number 2, easily we can turn off our SCR number 1. Let's take some more waveform to analyze these things. See here. Now it is your current through the capacitor. So this current is the current through the capacitor. Now the capacitor voltage started with this positive voltage. During this period, this capacitor is discharging and reverses its polarity. I have given 100 volt supply to the DC source. So the capacitor initially charged with 100 volt, then it will be minus 100 volt. Now during this period, what happens? During this period, this phenomenon will take place. So the capacitor started with this voltage and finally it will be zero, and in between this one you are getting one current pulse, and the inductor voltage changes like this. The same thing you will observe there. You can see here, between this one, this capacitor voltage, it is discharging. Here it is positive voltage to negative voltage, and here this inductor voltage from negative to positive, and this is our current pulse. So within this period, capacitor changes its polarity, and after that diode gets reverse bias and the current becomes zero. So no current will flow through the capacitor, so the current is zero. Now this happens when you are giving firing pulse to SCR number 1. So this is red one, gate pulse for SCR number 1. So as soon as you are giving firing pulse to SCR number 1, as soon as you are giving firing pulse here, then this capacitor will discharge through this one, and quickly it will develop the negative polarity here, and the diode will get reverse bias and the current will be zero. So this stored energy across the capacitor remain intact till you are not firing SCR number 2. So at this point you are firing SCR number 2, then again the capacitor will discharge to zero, then charge to again 100 volt. So it will remain there with this polarity, and when you will give firing pulse to SCR number 1, then again the same phenomena will take place and it will change its polarity, and inductor voltage also it will change its polarity, and you will get a current pulse there. Let's take few more waveform. What will happen to the output voltage now? Now here firing pulse to SCR number 1, as soon as you have given, then this current through the SCR we have seen just now, and till this point SCR number 1 is on, and as soon as you have given firing pulse to SCR number 2, SCR number 1 turns off. Here you can see SCR number 1 is off. Now during this period, what will happen to the output voltage? You can see, so here thyristor number 1 is on, so you can see this output voltage equal to input voltage. 100 volt supply I have given, so you can see this one. So this supply voltage is there, SCR number 1 is on. Simply you can see this voltage is across this one, so the output voltage equal to input voltage, so 100 volt you are getting across this one. Now this 100 volt remains there till this point. So what is this point? So this point you are just turning on the SCR number 2, then the voltage increases to 200 volt. Let's see the reason behind it. As soon as you are making SCR number 2 on, here it is what? 100 volt, but with negative polarity. And here it is negative positive, and here it is negative positive. So net voltage equal to what? This DC input voltage plus this capacitor voltage. So 100 plus 100, 200 volt. Now this 200 volt appears across the load. So the output voltage becomes 200 volt. And slowly this voltage will come down to 0, then to 100 volt. Then finally you will see here the voltage will be 0, and the inductor will discharge through this diode at that time. So you can see here. See, so when SCR number 1 was on during this period, the voltage was 100. As soon as SCR number 2 is made on, this voltage becomes 200 volt, because the input voltage plus the capacitor voltage becomes 200 volt. Now the capacitor is getting charged, so the potential difference decreases, and finally at this point capacitor voltage becomes 100 volt, so the net voltage across the output becomes zero because no current is flowing through the either of the SCR. At the same time, freewheeling diode is turned on because of the change in polarity of the inductor voltage, so the voltage becomes zero. Now again at this point you are turning the thyristor number 1 on, so same thing it will be repeated. So from here it is clear that if you want to make your thyristor number 1 or the main thyristor off, then you have to take help of thyristor number 2, that is also known as auxiliary thyristor. So today we have discussed about commutation circuit of SCR, one of the most important circuit, voltage commutation we have discussed, and we have concluded that to make the main thyristor off, you have to take a LC circuit and a auxiliary thyristor. From the next class, we will see some other topic of power electronics. Thank you.